Hello, my name is Quinn Moore, and welcome to Gossip Guys, the brand new show at North Central that covers controversial topics among students and faculty around the entire school. Today, we will be focusing on Senior Honor Code as well as the new parking lot. But first, we need to meet the Gossip Guys. Hello everyone. Today I'm here with Ian and we're interviewing other Ian. And other Ian is ranked number one in the senior class and he had some trouble getting his senior honor code. Take it away, Ian.
All right. So now that you have senior honor code, tell us about some of your struggles to get senior honor code.
Well, initially at registration, I checked to see if I had senior honor code. And I was expecting to have it because I met other requirements and I did the MIP project. But they said I didn't have the requirements and that they would look into it for me. And they wrote my name on a list with other students with the same problem. And the first week of school, I checked and they said they would get to students and call them down with passes, which I saw some of my classmates being called down. And then I never got called down. So the second or third week, depending on how you want to count those first 2 days, I went in to check and they admitted to being unorganized and not really knowing like how to go about the problem because there were so many seniors complaining about the same thing. And they said they kind of just hope the seniors would come to them instead of them doing their job and giving passes out.
Yeah, the same situation actually happened to me. I went to registration, they didn't give me senior honor code, and I went to Palacio's office, and they said I didn't have like parts of MIP project done, and they interviewed or they emailed my supervisor, and it turned out I did. So this is like the same situation. They just were unorganized about this project. That happened 2 years ago. That's just like not letting all these seniors get senior honor code, even though they've been such good like students. They've had good grades and good attendance for all 3 years of high school.
Yeah, and even that they did everything that met the requirement to get senior honor code, both of these two Ians still didn't get it. All right, so do you think that the personal project should be required in order to get senior honor code?
I personally don't have an opinion on that, but I do think if they do require it, they should let the students know before they assign the project, because when we started the project, it was not public knowledge that senior honor code would be tied to this project. And then rumors started spreading like midway through the project that it could be tied to it, but there was no confirmation from administration at that point.
Yeah, I remember that. It was just so like wishy-washy, like if it's going to be required or not. All right, so now that you have senior honor code, what do you think about the new parking at North Central?
I personally don't have a problem with it because I'm a senior, but I know juniors and sophomores will definitely have a big backlash on it, especially second semester once more sophomores start driving because of the new parking lot system. And they took away the natatorium parking spots for buses, which I know has a point to doing it to get elementary school and middle school students home. But I just feel like last year without senior honor code, I had to drive 15 minutes earlier second semester in order to get a spot. And I can't imagine how much early they're gonna have to drive.
Yeah, because now that they moved all these senior honor code spots back from the natatorium parking lot, into the student parking lot. It takes away a lot of these parking spots for seniors that don't have senior honor code, juniors and sophomores getting their license around the second semester. So I can imagine it would be super hectic second semester.
Yeah, I've gotten to school at 7:05, which is like 10 minutes before the first bell rings, and I've seen underclassmen parking at the tennis house and JEL, and they have to walk a long way, and they could be late for class. And this is really bad for like some of the seniors that didn't get senior honor code, like when they got cheated out of it. Like they've been good students all 3 years, and now they have to like get there really early to park.
All right. I'd like to thank you, Ian.
Thank you
for coming in for this interview. It's always a pleasure, Ian.
And pleasure.
That's a wrap.